Hey folks, Serdar here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Visual Studio Code as a database exploration and querying tool. Now, Visual Studio Code's a lot more than just a text editor. It is that, to be sure, but thanks to its rich and growing culture of add-ons, it's become a framework for working with many other kinds of things. Many programming projects involve a database of some kind, and it's handy to be able to examine and query the database without having to switch to another application. So here, we're going to look at a few add-ons for Visual Studio Code that allow you to work elegantly with databases right inside of Visual Studio Code itself. Let's start with an extension that's designed to work with one of the most common databases around, SQLite. This extension is called SQLite 3 Editor. I'll link to its page and the pages for the other extensions in the description for this video. This lets you take an SQLite database and open it directly in Visual Studio Code as if it were a text document, or maybe better to say, an Excel spreadsheet. Once you've opened the database, you can query its tables interactively, and you can make changes interactively too. You can also inspect and alter table schemas, although I recommend backing things up before making any destructive changes like this. Plus, you can write and run queries in a separate query editor, and import and export data in a variety of common formats. It's almost as full-blown an editor for an SQLite data as some of the standalone applications I've seen. Now, if you want to work with other databases than just SQLite, another extension to look at is called SQL Tools. When you install the SQL Tools extension, you can also install other extensions that allow it to connect to specific databases. So here, I have the extension installed for connecting to MySQL, and I've got a local MySQL database which I can explore and run queries on. So you'll notice we have this nice browsable tree here in the side with each connection we can make to a database and all the tables in the database. The interface does not have the same kind of interactivity as the SQLite extension I demonstrated, so if you want to modify records, for instance, you have to write out a modification query by hand. But the query editor interface does have some very nice auto-suggest functionality. So for instance, if I start a new query and I type select star from socula.film, where film ID is greater than 10, you can see the way it's auto-suggesting stuff all along the way. Also note that if you want to run commands that need to be run from the MySQL command line client, you'll have to actually open the client and run the commands there for that. So for instance, the source command, which is used to load SQL scripts from a file, that would have to be executed from the client. We can't run it in a query here. Now, of these two, I'm personally more enamored of the way the SQLite 3 editor extension works because of how much more interactive it is. I'd love to see something for MySQL that works the same way. But this should give you an idea of what's possible in Visual Studio Code if you want to work directly with databases and not have to switch away to a different window or app to do it. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.